Fetch.ai is a Cambridge-based artificial intelligence lab, and it is building an open source network to enable autonomous software agents to perform useful economic work on behalf of individuals, businesses, and organizations. And Humayun Sheikh, the CEO and founder of Fetch.ai, joins us today. And also Michael Reuter, the founder and CEO of Datarella from Munich in Germany. So we're truly global here today. We've got New York and Germany and London, or England at least. So good to see you guys.
These days, it doesn't matter. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
So Humayun, let's start with you. Like, how are you addressing smart cities and the opportunity in smart infrastructure?
Yeah, I think in today's world, we can see there is a lot of data trapped, and there's a lot of valuable data which is trapped in all these siloed places where you have the IoT devices all spread across the infrastructure. And I think we need to really try and bring all of this together in a smart cities kind of smart infrastructure way, so that you can actually tap into all the devices, you can tap into all the data and start bringing value out of it. And there is more value when you can actually correlate with each other, and you can bring different things together to kind of bring out more meaning from the devices and the data. Mm-hmm. And I think the smart cities, in the ability to deploy these different IoT devices and extract data from them and bring it all together is really what we are focusing on Fetch.
Mm-hmm. And then you're doing some field trials too over the next few months. So explain what kind of information you hope to glean from that.
So initially we started with some more academic trials. We did some trials with Warwick University, where we reduced energy utilization of the university by 20% using multi-agent systems. We also did a trial with a couple of other partners, and I think Michael Datarella was also part of that, where we did mobility trials, and we brought the electric vehicle efficiency and the whole journey cost down by 30%, and the time it took to charge by another 20%.
Perfect time to bring you in, Michael, and explain what you're doing in Munich with smart cities and infrastructure.
Yeah, absolutely. So we are Datarella, and we are enterprise blockchain solutions provider. So we have been working with all things blockchain since 2015, and we work for huge corporations, for huge organizations like World Food Program, United Nations, and so forth. And together with Fetch, we have been working for quite a time. And we have, since we are very practical guys, we always look for benefits of technology for the client, for the customer, for the end user. And since we have very dense populations in Munich, especially in the city center or in other European cities, there are huge problems with commuter traffic jams, with inoptimal parking space management, and so forth. And we are now using several buildings, several corporate real estate properties, with existing parking space, and we have started to build a product that manages this parking space in a better way, so that employees of tenants in these corporate real estate properties find their parking space faster. They actually find parking space, and that is one of the most interesting aspects of this project. They are incentivized not to use their individual cars at all. So we incentivize them because we know if they use the parking space or not. If they don't use the parking space, but instead use public transport. So then they get digital coins in their wallets and will be incentivized.
Yeah, no, very interesting. So it's this, the use of technology to, number one, make life easier and less of a hassle and help the environment. And what are kind of, you talked a little bit about it, finding parking places, but what are some practical ways that just everyday people would be able to benefit from this?
Yeah, that's a very good question. So you might know that there are many parking spaces existing parking spaces, but inaccessible parking spaces. So there are lots of buildings with parking space, and especially in within city limits, there are corporate parking spaces that will be that won't be used after working hours, but which could be used by public by the public, mm-hmm. and that is exactly what we will be doing.
Absolutely. Okay. So, Humayun, finally, we talked a few times. I mean, give me an update on where the business is and what do you hope to achieve next? What are some of your near-term goals?
Yeah. So we made some very good progress in terms of development and trials, in terms of more contained trials, academic trials. This is a very major step for us to go out and start deploying in the real world with the real solutions, with the real devices and real business cases. So what you'll see from us over the coming months, a year, is a lot more deployment, which is going to go out. We'll be building a lot more commercial solutions with commercial partners, and we will be looking to bring out this multi-agent system fabric, which we have now designed and is now in its operational form, able to commercialize this new way of doing business. As Michael was saying, if you think about it, you know, if you want to find a parking space, going to Google is not really the option. You have to kind of look at this particular app and find a parking space. And even then, it doesn't tell you where the parking space is. So the new way of doing business is an agent can communicate with tens of these parking places, wherever the parking is available. It calls you, it reserves it for you. It improves the efficiency of actionable predictions and actionable data. And that's really what you'll see from us over the next few months.
Well, and very helpful information. I mean, just for living day-to-day life. I mean, not having to waste time driving over a parking space is huge. So in addition to all the other applications that Fetch is able to do. Well, thank you so much, Humayun. Congratulations on your partnership with Michael as well. And I appreciate you giving the update today. Best of luck.
Thank